2 of my Spider-Man miniseries, The Comparison. Now, if you saw my review, I did a little background on all movies and references and all that, but this video is where we get to the nitty-gritty. And we compare the newest one, Spider-Man Homecoming, with the Spider-Man Trilogy and the Amazing Spider-Man Duology, and see if Homecoming is worthy and stuff. So, without further ado, let us begin. Starting with Part 1, the main guy. All three Spider-Man franchises have Spider-Man himself, and he is portrayed by three actors in all of them: Tobey Maguire, Andrew Garfield, and Tom Holland. And so, Tom Holland portrays Peter Parker and Spider-Man in Homecoming, and he does a pretty good job being Peter Parker, better than Tobey Maguire, that is, since he's not, he can express more teenage angst and uncomfortability and shyness and nervousness and maybe peer pressure. But as the movie progresses, he becomes a little bit more mature than his peers, notably Flash. And in the Spider-Man roles, Andrew Garfield takes the cake. Because despite Tobey Maguire doing Spider-Man with witty puns and cheeky dialogue, Andrew Garfield's dialogue as Spider-Man was a little more comic accurate. Meanwhile, Tom Holland's, it's not that great, because he doesn't make any cheeky puns or witty dialogue, but he does keep the naivety of Spider-Man in the comics. So, yeah, my definition for Tom Holland is like, he's average. He's better than Tobey Maguire in his Peter Parker parts, but he's not good as Spider-Man like Andrew Garfield was. So, yeah, he's in the middle. Now we go to Part 2. The suit. In the original Spider-Man trilogy, Spider-Man's suit looked really awesome. It was accurate to its comic books, had the eyes really good, the webbing was awesome, the design, it looked spot on. Now for the Amazing Spider-Man, there are two variations. There was one that had the black eyes, and is slightly different than from the original Spider-Man trilogy, but it definitely got a major makeover 2 years later, where he looks way more like his comic book counterpart and his Tobey Maguire movies. So, and the eyes changed back to their shade of white. So, for the newest one, it's a little bit off, unless you count the comics of the 60s as a part. So, the one thing they got right in Spider-Man Homecoming were the eyes, because they seem to widen, narrow, and all that. Now, for its webbing, it's similar to the Amazing Spider-Man, where he uses mechanical web shooters to use it, but unlike in that series, you actually have to press a button to shoot it, and you get a different array of weapons not available in previous comics or movie installments. So, Spidey suit is definitely more improved weaponry-wise and mask-wise. No, not really. And eye-wise, it's still not that iconic as his previous counterparts. But it's still a wordy suit. Still a wordy suit it is. And so my rating for the suit is about a draw. Because look at them. All three suits. They look amazing. So, it's hard for me to decide which one is deserving to be the top tier player. But for now, the suit is a tie. Nice bump. Which now leads us to part 3. The soundtrack. Yes, I do care about the soundtrack. For various reasons. One, it could make Spider-Man's theme look heroic, yet also quirky at the same time. And also, that they don't use too much licensed songs. So throughout the course of history, Spider-Man's series has gone through many composers, which were Danny Elfman, Christopher Young, James Horner, Hans Zimmer, and recently Michael Giacchino, I think. So, put on some headphones and indulge yourself in clips of the main themes of the Spider-Man soundtracks, and it's up to you to decide which one's the best. So, here they are. We'll be right back. good. Well, except for the Amazing Spider-Man one. Because it's such a shame that the sequel to that one had a better theme. But, come to think of it, the Homecoming theme doesn't sound too far off from what the original Spider-Man trilogy tried to do. Or what the Amazing Spider-Man 2 tried to do. So yeah. It just needs a little work. Like, incorporate more of the familiar Spider-Man doodle. Like they did at the opening scene when the Marvel Studios logo was released. I wish they should have just put Spider-Man Homecoming title there instead. That would have been better. But still, I have to give the original Spider-Man trilogy the high note. Spider-Man Homecoming was really close, but not that close. So yeah. Which leads to part 4, comic book characters. Now aside from Peter Parker himself, like we all need somebody else from the comics to be in the movie. The original Spider-Man trilogy had, aside from Peter Parker, Mary Jane, Flash Thompson, Uncle Ben, Aunt May, Jameson. Oh, that guy, he should have come back in Homecoming. Green Goblin, Doc Ock, Sandman, Venom, regrettably, the New Goblin, and, what else, Betty Brant, Gwen Stacy, Captain Stacy, like, tons. I could just keep going on and on. The Amazing Spider-Man had, except from Peter Parker, Gwen Stacy, Captain Stacy, the Lizard, Rhino for a little bit, Green Goblin, Electro, in a different form. Jameson, and although not seen on screen, which kind of sucks, because I wanted to see J.K. Simmons reprise his role. That would have been pretty cool. Basically, they have the least amount. Mary Jane was going to be put in, but her part was cut out. So much for that. Now for Homecoming, we don't have either Mary Jane or Gwen Stacy. So sorry, romantic Spider-Man fans. All we have is Michelle. And what else? Almost none others. No other comic people. Aside from the Vulture. And Iron Man. And what else? Captain America and a few cameos. And every other person in stock footage. We have a cameo by Betty Brant in her teenage years. I definitely cannot use to seeing her as a high schooler, more like Jameson's intern. So yeah, Homecoming did not improve much into its diversity of comic book characters. But then again, there is a sequel planned, so better keep our eyes peeled for any other comic book appearances. Because maybe, someday maybe it'll catch up to Sam Raimi's trilogy. So for now, in comic book characters, it's not that much to say. It's about tied with the Amazing Spider-Man duology. That's about it for that. And finally, we get into part 5, worthiness. Is it worthy to be called a Spider-Man movie? Well, for sure it's more worthy than Spider-Man 3 because of Emo Peter and his dance routine. But is it worthy to be in the ranks? Don't know about all of you, but still believe it's still a worthy movie to watch, hence the box office weekend. Still a worthy movie to watch, but after watching it, I recommend you guys pop in the original first Spider-Man movie into the old VCR or PlayStation 2 and see how it really should have been. And I'm not talking about Uncle Ben's death need to be repeated or anything, but We certainly could use a more wiser anime than what we had in Homecoming. I mean, I'm glad that they re-aged her from being a Playboy girl in Civil War to a more wiser one in Homecoming, which still doesn't offer any advice, to say the least. Yeah, it's still worthy to watch. Just don't follow any continuity with any other MCU events if you're not that into the other movies. But still, look at this. Definitely pulled Spider-Man out of the supposed trash heap that many YouTubers claimed that The Amazing Spider-Man 2 had pulled in. Gotta admit, it was packed with too many villains. Like, why was Rhino even there? Green Goblin should have been for another time. But, yeah, you win some, you lose some. So, that concludes my comparison video. If you like this video and my comments, please give this video a like, comment below on what your opinions think about Spider-Man, how it compares to the other movies. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more of me, OKOG98, and my pals, Jimmy Retro and the Chango. So, and stay tuned for tomorrow, because tomorrow I'm going to be releasing part 3 of my Spider-Man miniseries, The Top List, which is what everyone I bet is itching to see. After all, many other critics and other YouTubers dashed out their top list, so why don't I do one? Can't wait till tomorrow. We'll click on the subscribe button. Until then, I'll just enjoy this clip of the Spider-Man 2 final swing and just keep on stomping.